Okay, I think, yeah, we are good now, finally. I've had a weird morning. I'm trying to get this live stream going, all sorts of problems. Facebook cut me off twice. I had a little audio problem on my end. But actually, the problem is I forgot to turn on the transmitter for the wireless mic. First of all, just to give you a little bit of background, and I think in all fairness, I should say this, guys, because a lot of people don't know who I am, even though I thought, you know, I've been around for a long time. Let me just let you guys know, I started online in 2009 part-time when I was working a full-time job, okay? I started with this, guys, and I was doing affiliate marketing type of stuff. And in 2012, I switched to e-com, or I started to make the transition. 2012, I did both e-com and affiliate marketing. 2013, I went full in on e-com, and I've been doing e-com ever since. And that entire time, my number one main traffic source was Facebook advertising, okay? I've also been a coach and trainer doing Facebook ads. So I'm literally spent the last 12 years of my life looking at Facebook ads every single day with an occasional day off here and there, okay? Let's just say I know a thing or two about Facebook advertising, and I've seen a lot of changes. I've seen a lot of quote unquote catastrophes and problems, and every time it's blown out of proportion. Every single time it's blown out of proportion. And this time too, people panicking about this iOS thing is just completely blown out of proportion. Okay, I'm gonna talk about the issue with iOS and three potential solutions, okay? But I also wanna address something else here. And that is the July slowdown. Oh my God, the number of people I see in different groups saying, oh, sales are bad, sales are bad, sales are bad. This, oh, iOS is destroyed for the happening. Fucking bullshit. Fucking bullshit, and excuse my language, but I just want to tell exactly what it is. It's not true at all. I guarantee you, if you go back and look at older posts in July last year, and the year before, people are complaining about bad sales on Facebook in July and August. This is a hard time to sell, but the upside is it's also a great time to sell, because what most people are doing it wrong. They're trying to sell the stuff they would sell in the fall, in the spring, in the summer. And people are more careful with their money in the summer because they're focused on vacations and activities with the family and stuff like that and being active. So the key is to think about and identify product types and products that they need now. If you can get a hot summer product going now, they need now, you'll be blown away. I've had students just do incredible numbers, and I've done really well in the summer too. Summer can be an incredible season because most people do it wrong. Okay, I want you to do it right. Now let's talk about iOS. Okay, what's the deal? Okay. All right, so the main three metrics that I personally use, right, and a lot of people look at cost per impression, all sorts of stuff. I look at three things. Purchase, add to carts, link clicks. That's it. Purchase, add to cart, link clicks, all I care about. And maybe shares and comments. I want to see if people are active in my posts or not. Facebook can continue to track link clicks no matter what, because that action takes place on Facebook's platform. However, what's happening now is from iOS 14.0, Apple has enabled its users, if they choose to opt out of being tracked on ads. In other words, the purchase data and the add to cart data, okay? And so some people are doing so. Some people are doing that. And by the way, it's not the big unmitigating disaster as I mentioned earlier. It's not. So don't believe the hype. Don't believe the BS, okay? So here's three potential solutions. Number one, this is the most complicated solution, but it's also the most accurate one. Use the UTM tags when you set up your ads and have Google Analytics on your site. That's it. That's it. Work with Google Analytics and that's it. And you can get incredibly accurate data, okay? The other solution is this. Okay, so we know that you may have, for example, on a given day, you may have like 50 sales today, but maybe only 40 of them or 30 of them are actually showing up, right? Well, let's assume, just for the sake of argument, for the sake of example of what I want to talk about, you're making $20 of the cost per goods and shipping, right, on your product. Well, I always, when I go for my ads, I'm looking for ad sets and campaigns that are doing better than $20 or less per purchase, right? So that I want to be constantly profitable. I'm building the pixel. I want to build my mailing list because I'll take as many customers on mailing list as possible and add the cards, because lifetime value of customers is one of the most important concepts in building a long-term e-com brand. But, so all I care about is, am I getting purchased for $20 or less? All right, so am I making a profit or at least breaking even on my front end sale, right? And I know now with iOS that all sales can be tracked. Well, why not just use the same metrics that you've always done? Because think about this. Just think about it for a second here. This is actually a beautiful thing. I know for a fact that my break-even point is $20, right, per purchase. And I also know for a fact that a certain percentage of my sales are not going to be tracked because of iOS people are opting out of being tracked. Well, in my ads reports, if I'm getting sales at $20 or less, there's no way I'm not profiting because there's extra sales coming in that cannot be tracked. So there's no reason to panic whatsoever. Just read the data as usual. Okay, now, there is one. I have one student in particular who's got an extreme situation, right? She is targeting women. I don't want to say what type of women, but targeting certain women, like 99% women niche, okay? And they are very savvy shoppers. And a lot of them have opted out of iOS, okay? A lot. I mean, a much higher percentage than I'm seeing personally and other mother people, right? So she is literally, she'll have a situation where her Shopify store will say 60 sales and her Facebook pixel will say 30. Okay? Well, that's easy. Just think to yourself, okay, well, I know I'm usually getting 2 sales for everyone spent, right? So you could actually, in this scenario I just said, you could say, well, if I get in purchases on my ads report for $40 or less, I'm good. But maybe that's a little too aggressive, right? So I told her, let's go 1.5. So in the example that I'm talking about here of the $20 margin after cost of goods and shipping, in her case, you'd want to go, okay, am I getting 30 purchases for $30 or less on this, okay? Doesn't tell the whole story here. So that's a little thing I want you to add on to this, okay? So if I know I got a lot of untracked sales, period, and I know that basically, you know, I got to account for that. So instead of going $20 or less, I say $30 or less. But here's the thing. Look at one other thing. And that's something that Facebook can track accurately. That is link clicks. Okay, so I don't just look, in her case, I say we don't just look at just the $30 or less, right? And based on the example margin I'm just giving you, right? But we also look at the link clicks. So if we have a combination of, based on our estimate, a good cost per purchase, and we've got good link clicks, we know we're good. We know that's probably a winning, we know we can't say 100,000% with 100% accuracy, but we have a 95 to 98% chance that is a winning ad set. So we leave it running. We leave that campaign running. That asset or campaign running. This is Chris Blair. Guys, don't panic about this. And by the way, you can totally make nice profit in summer if you want to do it right. If you're interested in my private coaching, private messaging, I can take on one coaching student at this time. The other day, I posted on my Facebook, someone who's had massive success with my coaching, he messaged me and said, basically, I wish I would have signed up for your coaching a long time ago. I was scared. The amount of times I've heard that particular, or something similar to that, people who waited and hesitated and hesitated and hesitated and finally pulled the trigger and then said, oh, fuck, I wish I'd done it sooner. I don't want you to be one of those persons. So private message me, sign up for my coaching today. If not, if you really don't feel you can afford my coaching, then go to ecomvantage.com, ecomvantage, V-A-N-T-A-G.com, and sign up for $100 a month for my course in Mastermind, and we'll see you in the next video. Cheers.